Welcome back to History Lessons. So today I'll discuss about the radical nationalist, which is a part of class 10 ICSE board syllabus. So we have a video still moderate phase of Indian nationalism and also about the how the Congress formed and all. So today I will discuss mainly about the radical leader, so the assertive nationalist. There are several names by which they are known. We will discuss about the famous trio Lal Bal Pal, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Bipin Chandra Pal. So their two contributions each, and also about the objectives and method of struggle of the radical leaders. And your syllabus also has a part on how the partition of Bengal took place. But it has already been done in one of our videos for class 11 ISC board. So please refer to that video. The link will be given in the description box. And for this video, I'll be referring to Total History and Civics class 10 standard. And Amazon link of the same book will also be given in the description box. So now coming back to the lecture, the radical nationalists, by the name itself we can understand their views. So we can see that in the beginning 20 years of moderate phase, we see the dominance of those leaders who are moderate in their way of struggle. And after that, they lost their significance, people lost faith in them. And then there was a turn in 1905, and 1905 onwards we see the radical nationalists coming and taking their position in the hold of Congress and also taking the nationalism movement, that is the Indian struggle for freedom. So here the role of Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal and Lala Lajpat Rai is very, very significant in their own way, in their own areas. Tilak is mainly from Western India. Bipin Chandra Pal is from Eastern India, and Lala Lajpat Rai is from Punjab Kishi. So we will discuss those. So firstly, the objectives. Their objective was Swaraj. Tilak made it very, very clear that in his famous statement that Swaraj is my birthright and I'll have it. So they were not satisfied with the dominion status, with the moderates were satisfied with, and they wanted full freedom of India. And they took their measures in that manner, and their measures were quite radical, and thus they were known as assertive or radical nationalists. So they had the objective of full freedom for India, and their method of struggle, there are four very famous methods of struggle: revivalism, Swadeshi, boycott and national education. So they wanted to revive like the ancient good old days of India. Like Tilak revived the Shivaji festival, Ganpati festival, and there was certain Hindu tinge in their nationalist movement. So there has been criticized later also for bringing communalism or sowing the seeds of communalism in India or Indian struggle for freedom. So revivalism or reviving the ancient age of Indian was an important method of radical nationalists. Then comes Swadeshi and boycott. So Swadeshi is one, boycott is one, but they are the two sides of the same coin. Swadeshi means boosting up the own industries or like khadi and all to satisfy their own domestic needs and not depending on others for the needs. And boycott of foreign institutions, boycott of foreign cloth, boycott of foreign any material which is foreign, particularly British in this case, so that it's a way of struggle, it's a way of method of going against the Britishers who are the colonialists here. So Swadeshi and boycott go hand in hand, and then the national education, which is very important. So national education is educating people so that they can work for further cause of India's struggle for freedom and Indian national freedom, which they achieved later in 1947. So this is all about the method of struggle and objectives of radical nationalists. Then come the famous three leaders or radical leaders. Firstly, Bal Gangadhar Tilak. You will get to see a lot of contributions of them. You have to learn any two. So if there are questions will come, any two contributions, and out of which I will refer that Tilak's one contribution should also be, like, should always be mentioned, is about Tilak's political belief that Swaraj is my birthright, I'll have it. So Swaraj was a man M. Then his role in the anti-partition movement, you can Right, or you can also write a very important point, the forerunner of Gandhi. He is known as the forerunner of Gandhi. Although Mahatma Gandhi regarded Gokhale as his political guru, his ideas were molded by Tilak's thoughts in big way also. So Gandhi led great stress and prohibition, Swadeshi and boycott. All these had been preached and practiced by Tilak much before Gandhi. Thus, Tilak has also been known as forerunner of Gandhi. So two contributions of Tilak done. Then come Bipin Chandra Pal. His role in awakening national consciousness in India. Bipin Chandra joined Congress in 1887 after 2 years of its formation. So at the Chennai Congress in 1887, he made a forceful speech in which he pleaded that Arms Act should be repealed. There were the Vernacular Press Act, Arms Act, Seditious Meetings Act. So there he protested strongly against the Arms Act. Then you can also write about an active role in anti-partition and Swadeshi movement in Bengal's partition, anti-partition movement. He has an active part also in the Swadeshi movement, which goes hand in hand with the anti-partition movement in Bengal. So there goes the two contributions of Bipin Chandra Pal. Lastly, we come to the end of the lecture, like Lala Lajpat Rai's two contributions. Again, we can have a repetitive point of his role in the anti-partition and Swadeshi movement. He also, we discussed earlier, and the radical nationalist and a brave fighter, and demonstration against the Simon Commission. Try to write something which is different from the other contribution of other leaders. So write this one, demonstration against the Simon Commission. Simon Commission was a very, a commission, it's also known as White Commission, because there were no Indian members in the commission. So Lala Lajpat Rai vehemently criticized the commission and raised his voice against it. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching me. Please like, share and subscribe History Lessons for more historical facts. Thank you.